today on Las Vegas Now.
Diamonds may be a girl's best friend, but see why one billboard has ladies saying no to jewelry.
And the TSA pats a 13-year-old boy down, and some say it went overboard. Why his mother is demanding an apology.
And spinach is really good for you. What scientists are now doing with this super veggie.
You are watching Las Vegas Now with Lindsey Simon, Kendall Tenney, and Mercedes Martinez.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Las Vegas Now. We have the whole team here today.
Whoa, how about this?
Mercedes, we got the whole game.
It's fun. We rarely get to do this, and it's so much fun. We look forward to it on the days we do get to all be together.
Yes.
This hasn't happened since day one, has it?
Is this the first time since
day
one?
Yeah.
That's how rare it is.
Where's Wayne? Where's Wayne Newton? Yeah. We need him back, too.
That's right.
He's somewhere around here. We'll find him.
We got a lot coming up today, and a lot of people are still buzzing, of course, about the Raiders.
Yes.
It looks like coming here as a result of the NFL vote. And you have already purchased or at least put a deposit down on season tickets?
You know, they went on sale today, and I know we have more details coming up in the news on this. But, yeah, you could put a $100 deposit down on seats. And so my husband and I, we did it. And they give you a choice. They say A, B, C, D, E, and F on the tiers that you want to go with. And so, of course, my husband decides he wants to go with the A tier.
Absolutely. Ooh. If you're going to go big.
Oh, yeah, but they have dollar signs next to each one, and that was like $4 or $5 signs. I'm like, might have to take out a loan
here. It didn't give you an actual price, just
dollar signs.
Oh, that's disconcerting.
I'm really
scared. You're in trouble.
I'm on the hook.
You're going to take out a loan.
If I see dollar signs on Yelp, I'm like, nah.
On the restaurant?
Yeah,
like $5 signs?
Taco Bell.
Nah, I'll skip it. Yeah.
Well, should we expect another windy night tonight?
Let's send it over to the 8 News Now team with a look at today's headlines and a look at the weather.
All right, guys, thanks very much. Word is we could see another strong blow in the coming days.
Yes.
Yeah, if you thought today was bad, just wait, say instead.
Yeah, I'm the messenger. So just so you know, I'm just the messenger. Big winds expected later on in the week. The good news, though, the winds that we saw today, they are now decreasing. Take a look right now outside. Notice the camera not moving too much. Of course, that's going to change come Thursday and Friday. Why? We have high wind alerts already issued for Thursday and Friday, and it's not even Wednesday yet. That's telling us that those winds on Thursday, Friday are going to be big winds. All right, peak gusts for the day today. We're in the 40s for Red Rock, North Las Vegas. That doesn't surprise me because those winds, of course, coming from the north are stronger. Those winds coming off the mountains are stronger. Nellis at 38, Aliante 36, 34 for McCarran and Henderson. These are all your peak gusts for the day today. It's good to show those. We can now show those because those winds are not going to be in the 40s tonight. Unfortunately, those winds have also kicked up the pollen. Mulberry, pine, oak, ragweed all reporting high readings for all those allergy sufferers out there. It is the spring season, and we get those spring winds. Evening planner for tonight, we go from the 70s to the 60s. Notice breezy early and then calmer tonight. Some cool breezes tomorrow morning, 60 degrees at 8 a.m. You'll have a morning start right around the low to mid-50s. There's those weather alerts. Gusts 50 to 60 are possible on Thursday and Friday, and that's why a high wind watch has been issued specifically for Thursday for all these areas shaded in purple. That includes all counties. We'll have more on this because this is serious stuff. We'll have more on this and show you what to expect coming up at the end of the show. Christianne, we'll send it back to you.
Thanks, Ted. Well, Nevada will now receive federal disaster assistance after February's severe weather. That's going to help with state, tribal, and local public infrastructure recovery efforts. The approval follows a letter Governor Brian Sandoval sent to President Trump earlier this month. Now, if you remember, northern Nevada was plagued by winter storms, flooding, even mudslides from February 5th to the 22nd. Individual assistance for Washoe and Elko County is still under review.
Right now, police have shut down an intersection on the north side of the valley after a young person was injured in a crash. It happened near Washington and I Street shortly after 2 o'clock. We're told the little girl was taken to UMC in critical condition. Traffic is blocked off on Washington between H Street and I Street. The collision, cause of collision remains under investigation right now. And more sad news to report. Metro investigating a deadly pedestrian crash at the corner of Main Street and Owens. This accident happened in just the last hour or so. We're told a car hit a person at the intersection, and this area remains closed so police can investigate.
Red Cross is now helping two people following a massive mobile home fire in the northeast part of the valley. This happened shortly after 11 o'clock in the 2200 block of Christie near Nellis and Cary. Now we're told a mobile home caught fire and a gas leak interfered with firefighters' ability to battle that blaze. At this time, damages have not been estimated, and it's still unclear whether or not that gas leak sparked the fire. The cause remains under investigation.
A 73-year-old man is expected to spend the next 10 years behind bars after he admitted to plotting the death of an organized crime rival. Charles Stango was arrested back in 2015, along with other alleged members of the DeCavalcante crime family. Prosecutors say the family engaged in numerous offenses, including murder, extortion, and fraud. Six of Stango's co-defendants, including his son, have pleaded guilty to various charges. The suspect arrested in connection with the burglary of a high-end jewelry store in the Bellagio, due in court tomorrow, 20-year-old Sebastian Gonzalez, facing multiple charges. He's one of four suspects, some of whom you see here, involved in the crime, but police are still searching for the others. Police say the suspects all ran off the scene and unsuccessfully tried to carjack several vehicles. They were wearing tuxedos and a variety of animal masks. Anyone with information is urged to call Crime Stoppers. President Trump's latest executive order is an effort to dramatically change how the U.S. deals with climate change.
The action I'm taking today will eliminate federal overreach, restore economic freedom, and allow our companies and our workers to thrive, compete, and succeed on a level playing field for the first time in a long time.
The White House calling it an energy independence order. It'll start a review of the Clean Power Plant Initiative and rescind the moratorium on coal mining on U.S. federal lands. It also urges federal agencies to identify all regulations that stop the U.S. from being dependent on other countries for energy. The order rescinds at least six executive orders signed by former President Obama, including one that calls climate change a growing threat to national security. Meanwhile, the White House is denying that it tried to block former Deputy Attorney General Sally Yates from testifying before a House committee investigating the Russian influence during the 2016 presidential election. The hearing Yates was supposed to appear at was canceled. Democrats are calling for Republican Committee Chairman Devin Nunes to recuse himself from the investigation, claiming he cannot be impartial. Nunes viewed secret documents on White House grounds and briefed the president afterwards.
Well, just one day after the monumental announcement, Raiders fans can now secure their spot for the Las Vegas Stadium by making a $100 deposit. And it's important to note, it's refundable, especially for you, Mercedes. I heard you mention that earlier. You can purchase it at LasVegasStadium.com. Over at Oakland, we're calling it disappointment would be a huge understatement in describing the mood there. For the second time, the Raiders are leaving the Bay. City officials said they had a plan to build a new stadium, but their Hail Mary went incomplete, and now the mayor and fellow Oakland fans are sounding off against the Valley.
And so in Las Vegas, when their hotel taxes don't materialize as planned, they certainly can give us a call. We'll let them know what that feels like.
People go to Sin City for one reason: get drunk, belligerent, get some boobs shaked in their face. They're having fun, they're partying. They're not sitting here watching a game. That's not going to happen.
That was Voodoo Man. It's interesting to note, Oakland's stadium plan came at the final minute. The Raiders have been wanting a new stadium there for several years. There's word that the city of Oakland could give the Raiders the boot, and they'll need somewhere to play while the stadium is being built. Las Vegas making the most of their time in the national spotlight.
The historic news, the Raiders coming to town has become the biggest, one of the biggest sports stories of the year. John Treach has more on that.
Yeah, guys, in 1987, Las Vegas was changed forever when the Mirage Hotel and Casino went up on the Strip. To the disbelief, the Raiders relocating to Las Vegas is not a mirage, but it's a monumental moment in the city's history. Get your eye patch. The Silver and Black will be back, and they're staying for good. On Monday, the NFL approved the move from Oakland with a 31-1 vote. Now the construction and infrastructure challenge begins. The Raiders, in conjunction with Clark County funds, will build a $1.9 billion stadium. Wherever the Raiders hold their headquarters, the number one value is family. Started by the godfather and former owner Al Davis and passed down to his son Mark Davis and President Mark Badane.
You know, there's two kids, Mark Badane and myself. We were water boys as we started out in this organization. And a lot of people have grown in this organization for many, many, many years. And for us to be able to have finally achieved what something that we've tried to do for, you know, the last 30 years, I think he would be proud. And I think the whole organization should be proud because there's a lot of young people that have worked their way, and there's people that are going to be here their lifetime, and the organization is a family.
The next task to tackle is deciding where to pour concrete and raise the steel beams of the future. The stadium site has been narrowed down to two locations just south of the strip, one to the east of I-15 and one to the west. Now, the Raiders have a contract to stay at the Oakland Coliseum through 2018, but can the Bolting team and the Bitter Town play nice for 2 years? We'll see.
We certainly will. Thanks, John. Well, the first week of the Big Squeeze is officially over, and now that we've had a taste of it, we know what to expect.
Late last weekend, I put down even more cones in the area. For example, northbound 95, exit to South Rancho, is closed through mid-July. All is construction for Project Neon, the state solution to the spaghetti bowl mess. Next year, you will deal with more closures on I-15 as part of the project. If you really want to drill down into the specifics of what they're doing, go to n.projectneon.com for more information.
And that is all for this news update. Of course, we have much more news coming up at 5 and 6 o'clock.
Now back to Las Vegas now, guys.
All right. Thank you, guys. Okay, well, you know this. Dating can be difficult, especially in today's world with social media and all these dating apps. Well, to add to the stress, there are also new dating terms being used. So we're going to see if you all know what they mean. And I'm going to see if you all know what they mean. Okay. I've already looked these up. Laby. That is the first term.
Laby.
Laby. What does that mean? What do you think it means?
Oh, boy. They're probably not what the first thought of my mind. Let me think.
Same here. Same here.
I don't know. What do you think?
Maybe you're on the fence about someone.
Laby.
Like, oh, laby. Okay, yeah. Okay. Well, laby means someone who's in a relationship but is looking to get out. So you're pretty much right.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Basically, they're laying the groundwork with others to see who they might want to date next.
Who comes up with are these real terms? Are these the kids using these?
The kids? Yes.
The
yeah, they really
the
are
kids
using
these days.
Okay, here's the next one. Breadcrumbing.
Oh, I know this one. This is when it's like Hansel and Gretel, where you just leave little trails to keep someone chasing you, but you're not fully committed to them yet.
Yes.
Whoa, is that it?
Yes, it is, which is very, this is so rude for people to do. Breadcrumbing is a term, like you said, based from the story Hansel and Gretel, it involves leading someone on with a trail of flirtatious messages, but then there is never a follow through or progression of the relationship. So, you know, people like are texting you and they're like, oh, hey, and then you never get a follow up.
I'm like, oh, hey.
That's.
Okay, last one.
Okay.
Shipping. And I did not know what this one was.
Shipping.
Shipping.
S-H-I-P-P.
P-P.
Just gotta be careful with this
one. P-P-I-N-G.
Is it when you, like, are done with someone, so I'm shipping you to, I'm moving, I'm shipping you off.
I guess that.
That's a good guess. You're both wrong.
Wrong.
Okay. It means the opposite. This means those closest to you have endorsed or shipped your relationship.
Oh, the stamp of approval.
Yeah, okay. Stamp of approval. Yep.
Is it important for you to have your friend's approval of whoever you're dating or marrying?
I think so.
Yeah.
If you truly love the person and they don't like him but you still love him, then it's like whatever. But it's an added bonus when they also get along with your significant other.
Validation.
Yes.
At least support. Maybe not full.
Yeah.
You know, they don't have to love him, but support you when you break up with them a million times and get back together, you know?
That's the thing. If somebody breaks up, you never say, oh, she was wrong for you.
You can't.
Oh, no, we never liked her, because they're going to get back together. And then you have that awkward moment where you go, I was just kidding.
Yeah.
I really, really like her.
They're the best.
Yeah.
A jewelry store in North Carolina is facing serious backlash for this billboard. It reads, quote, sometimes it's okay to throw rocks at girls and has pictures of jewels. Now, critics, they protested outside of this family jewelry store with signs that read, kids see billboards and violent words lead to violence. Others on social media say that it promotes violence against women. Well, supporters say that people have just gotten too PC. Mm. The store did release a Facebook statement. They apologized for the billboard, saying that they don't condone violence of any kind and they are working to replace it. Is that too much? Crossing the line?
Yeah, because I think maybe people are too sensitive, but being in public relations, I know that you kind of weigh those things as you're coming up with a campaign.
Yeah.
Is someone going to be offended by this? And I'd say the likelihood of someone being offended by something like that is great. So just avoid it.
Yeah.
What would you say, because it said don't throw, sometimes it's okay to throw rocks at girls. What if it said sometimes it's okay to throw stones?
What's it? Oh, well, stones. That's
girls.
Okay. Rocks.
It doesn't
not
just
rocks.
Say girls.
It's stones.
Would that be better? I guess not.
Oh, you okay. Left out girls. Is that what
yeah.
It was?
Oh, and I changed rocks okay. To stones. So like.
Well, that was
don't
the big change.
Throw stones yeah. In a glass house.
I like it. Give them rocks or give them stones, but throwing them. I have a kid that sees that. They're gonna be like, oh, it's okay. It's on a billboard. Bam. Right. They don't realize it's yeah. Jewelry we're talking about.
Just playing
here.
With fire. All right, the Academy of Country Music Awards, less than a week away. You're going
yes,
to that, right?
I am this Sunday.
That's going to be so fun. We couldn't get. You're going probably.
No.
You go to everything in the city.
I need a break.
Okay.
No.
Well, you have a chance to go there. You head over to our Facebook page right now, facebook.com/LasVegasNowTV, to enter to win two tickets to attend the ACMs and two tickets to Party for a Cause at the Joint and the Palms. You have until Friday to win, but keep watching because we're going to have more chances to win right here. A TSA pat-down has sparked controversy. Find out why the mom of this boy says her son was traumatized by his encounter with airport security.
And how one mother's attempt to include her daughter resulted in a school ban. The story next on Las Vegas Now.
At RC Willie, choose one of these queen-size beds, now only $199. RC Willie.
Now, only at Planet Nissan.
Today on 8 News Now at 5, the Raiders have the green light on Vegas, but what's the next move? The latest stadium talks and when we could see the first kickoff. Plus, more cops, we're paying for them, so where are they? We're checking in on the recruits on 8 News Now at 5.
All right, today's talkers. This one's one that has gotten a lot of attention on the internet. One mom is filing a complaint with the TSA after they patted down her 13-year-old son who has a sensory processing disorder. Jennifer Williamson posted this Facebook video of a TSA officer patting down her son, Aaron. She says the experience left him traumatized. Now, it all started when a laptop was found in the teen's book bag. The TSA officer explained the procedure to him and then used the back of his hands to pat down the boy. Williamson says she asked that her son be screened in another way because of his disorder, which makes him sensitive to touch.
I believe he was patted down excessively. They went over his sensitive areas a little more than necessary, especially given that he wasn't wearing bulky clothing or anything like that.
Williamson says they were held at the checkpoint for about an hour, causing them to miss their flight. And the TSA says the pat-down took approximately 2 minutes in total, and two police officers were also called to go over the mother's concerns. And just recently, we reported the TSA was changing the way it pats down passengers who are going through screening, and it was going to be a little more thorough. And this is a result of that.
I felt like it was too much. You saw the little boy's face. He was really, you could tell he was traumatized by that. I felt like it was a little excessive.
Yeah. What else can they do for someone with his condition? What else can they do? Like, is there another screening or something? Because you don't want him to feel uncomfortable.
I know they give you the option of going to a private room, but I know it also can be traumatic for not just kids, but for adults as well, because it feels invasive, and it's unfortunate that this is the time we live in where these screenings have to take place.
Well, I went through TSA this weekend. I went home to Pittsburgh for the weekend, and I learned a trick. If you have a medallion or a necklace that's kind of dangling, she said, hey, ladies, like, throw it in the back. That way that if they find something, you know, if it dings off or whatever, they take the back of their hand on your back rather than your front.
Oh, that's a good idea.
So I did it. I'm going to do it every single time.
That's a good piece of advice, too.
You're welcome. Thanks, TSA lady. Well, a single mother in Georgia is banned from going to her daughter's father-daughter dance after dressing up like a man in order to attend. Amy Peterson says she filed paperwork a month ago letting the school know that she would be the one taking her daughter to the dance since her daughter does not have a father. Well, when the dance rolled around, the mother-daughter duo decided to dress Peterson up as a man to go to the dance. The two posted a photo on social media, and an hour later, the school called saying they would not be permitted into that dance.
How do you explain that to a six-year-old? You can't go to a dance because you don't have a male role model in your life.
Well, the school released a statement saying, quote, the school is cognizant that different dynamics exist across households in our school system. There are multiple parent engagement events and opportunities to participate with their kids annually at this school in an effort to make that connection and build school spirit. And they said they do have a spring fling. They do have like a father-daughter dance that they offer. What do you all think? Too far or
I think, what does it matter if this mom takes her daughter to the dance? I don't get why they were so stringent about it. What does it change for the other people attending the dance? I don't think it makes a difference. So why make a big deal of it and single this girl out? Because she doesn't have, apparently, a male role model who could go with her to the dance.
And that probably made her feel even worse about it. I agree. I think that, if anything, it could have been fun to see mom show up there. And I'm sure the other dads would have gotten a kick out of that. Yeah. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But we wanted to know what you guys think about this. Did the school go too far, or were they right to send them anyway? Let us know on our Facebook page, facebook.com/LasVegasTV. Let's see. Here's what some of you have to say. Greg says, good for the school. It was a dad event, and that is needed. If you let her in, then why not the other moms? Then it is not a dad bonding event.
Okay. Maria says, this is heartbreaking. My daughter had a father-daughter dance where my husband and I also attended and saw a few other moms there, too. What's the big deal with letting moms in this event that's actually run by moms?
Kobe posts, if there is no father around, then yes, because she is both mom and dad, and the little girl shouldn't suffer.
Let me say this, too. The school did a terrible job with its response, because if you notice the verbiage, we work in crisis communications all the time. The verbiage was very pedantic. It sounded very legal. We are cognizant of problems, and we have multiple events. You can't sound like that. You have to empathize with the people who are involved there, and that statement didn't do it at all.
Yeah, well,
it was very cold.
Do you think it's because she's a mom, or do you think it's because she dressed up like a dad?
Well, apparently she felt the need to dress up like a dad.
As someone who dresses up like a man every Halloween, I understand the intrigue, but I don't know. Like,
we need to explore this more. I want to hear more about this. The
show just got interesting.
There are pictures. All right, well, can't quite make it to the gym today. Try drawing a bath instead. Coming up, have similar effects to exercise.
But first, here's today's trivia brought to you by Rolot and Shutters. The most common hours for a burglary occur during what time of the day?
Introducing El Pollo Loco's $20 Grande Value Meal. Hey.
Welcome back to our trivia brought to you by Rolot and Shutters. The most common hours for a burglary to occur during the day is at what time? The answer? Between 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. Experts say most burglars try to break into your home when you're at work. And stats like that make you realize that you really need to take extra steps to protect yourself. And speaking of protection, Rolot and Rolling Shutters not only provides home security, but can help cut down your heating and cooling bills. One local homeowner shows us the benefits of having them in your home.
And Shutters, their customer service, they're just amazing company. I had seen a neighbor have them, and I had asked them, and I was like, what are those? And then my husband was even like, we're getting those. I came out and measured anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks, and then about 2 more weeks later, then they installed them. I mean, it's been a very painless process, and it's been amazing. We got them because of security. We also got them because I love to be in the dark sometimes. It's very dark when you go inside the house. It's on 16. I'm gonna lower. So then you push the up button, and it raises everything. Instant lights, very easy, extremely easy. They, you know, like I said, it's programmable, whatever you want to do, and it's customized to what you want. Usually they'll ask me what they are, and then I'll have to demonstrate. So I play with them a lot, and it's fun. We also have a basketball court on the other side, so when the ball hits the window, it'll just hit the roulette and shutter and not anything else. So you don't have to worry about the window ever breaking or anything like that. If we leave for the weekend, it's great to know that we can just press number 16 and just have everything come down, and we don't have to worry about anything. It's safe, secure, you don't have to worry about it. I love them.
To get more information about roulotte and rolling shutters, give them a call at 702-878-1072, or you can visit them at 6168 West Charleston Boulevard. Lindsey, over to you.
Okay, next on Las Vegas Now, you are what you eat. How spinach is literally becoming part of our bodies. That's coming up.
Furnishings for the Las Vegas Now Green Room, provided by Furniture Fashions.
This portion of Las Vegas Now is sponsored by Burnham Construction Services.
Furniture Fashions.
Only on 8 News Now.
To our floor director, Carlos, showing off the Golden Knights hat. He's already a fanatic. He is all in when it comes to the Golden Knights. Well, let's take a look at today's health news. I kind of doubt this one, I got to tell you. Taking a bath, they say, could have similar benefits to exercise.
I hope it's true.
Yeah, everybody hopes it's true. A study in one health journal, what health journal are we talking about, found that an hour-long soak in the tub produced similar anti-inflammatory and blood sugar responses as 60 minutes of moderate physical activity. Researchers studied two groups. One half did an hour of cycling, and another had a 104-degree bath. Those who took a bath had the blood sugar level about 10% lower than those who exercised. Actually, better than those who exercised. Scientists say more has to be done before they can reach a firm conclusion on this, but they say this could offer a good alternative to those who are unable to exercise regularly.
And a centuries-old aphrodisiac may help people with sleep apnea. Scientists have found that a chemical located in the bark of the African yohimbe tree may actually reverse the cause of the breathing problem. As a dietary supplement, this chemical has long been used to treat erectile dysfunction, been used as an aphrodisiac, and as a performance enhancer for bodybuilders. But this is the first time researchers have seen its benefits for sleep apnea.
Well, spinach is a natural superfood, but it may also one day create superhumans. Scientists in Massachusetts have found a way to turn spinach into a human heart muscle. Researchers took spinach veins and seeded them with human heart cells. In just a few days, the leaves' muscle cells actually began to beat.
That's crazy.
Yeah, the goal was to copy a human's vascular system. Using the leaf's veins, they hope to one day help treat heart attack patients with this new research.
What? And it's not April Fool's yet.
No, so that's no, that's real. Legit, okay. Supposedly. Right. Well, seafood lovers rejoice. Celebrity chef Rick Moonen is here to show off what he's cooking up for the big St. Rose Gala, or not cooking up, it's all raw. Raw fish.
Furniture for Las Vegas Now, provided by Walker Furniture. You are watching Las Vegas Now with Lindsey Simon, Kendall Tenney, and Mercedes Martinez.
All right, this is going to be a fun segment with two of my very good friends celebrating a big anniversary for Southern Nevada's only not-for-profit faith-based hospital. And we have with us celebrity chef Rick Moonen and Saville Kellner, who is heading up the St. Rose Foundation Gala coming up this Saturday.
It's coming up this Saturday, and we're so excited. We have a headliner, which is Jewel. We have the plain white tees. We have acts from Absinthe. It's going to be an amazing event. Our biggest concern is the MC. So we've got an MC that can turn this into an absolute disaster.
Who is it? Who's the MC?
Kendall Tenney.
Oh,
yes.
No.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
No.
Thank you.
But
I feel the love.
Besides Kendall, it's going
just,
to be amazing.
It's like a warm hug in
but
here.
But seriously, it's all for an amazing cause. Like I said, it's the 70th year celebration of the only religious non-for-profit hospital in town. Mm-hmm. We serve 200,000 people a year. Whether they can pay or not, we're there for them. The money for this event is going to help us serve even more people yeah. and continue this amazing run of 70
it's
years.
It's made a difference in so many people's lives, so happy to be a part of it. And Rick Moonen, of course, one of the premier chefs, not only here in Las Vegas, but in the world. And so we were so excited. Rick's coming, you know, fire up the oven, get the pots and pans out, and he walks in with raw fish. But that's great, Rick.
Hey, there
we're
you
glad
go.
You're here.
It's my pleasure, Kendall.
This is going to be a great event because of chefs like you who are going to be serving
tremendous cuisine.
Yeah, I've assembled a group of some of the greatest chefs in Las Vegas to come together. Actually, even the pastry chef, Megan Romano, is coming in from Arizona to do an amazing dessert. I'm going backwards here. We've got for the hors d'oeuvres and VIP sector, we have Susan Feniger from Border Grill. And then the guests, 650 guests get to sit down and start off with a combination with Saipin from the chef, a celebrated chef from Lotus of Siam with Kim Cantingwala from the Elizabeth Blau group, followed by a seafood course, not this one.
No.
That I'm influencing with at the Caesars catering department. Then the main course is unbelievable, and that's
Barry
date cake from Nine, and he's doing a surf and turf. And then, of course, Megan is going to be doing an amazing grand finale with roses and all kinds of things integrated to celebrate St. Rose Hospital.
I love it. I love that you started off with dessert, too. I think every gala should start that way. Start with the dessert and then go backward from there. Wow. You, of course, have RX Boiler Room, RM Seafood.
Yes.
A couple of burger joints, I don't know.
No,
you got stuff all over the place. But you have here some tremendous, beautiful layout
of
sushi.
This is just a kind of a cross-section of some of the things that we serve at RM Seafood in Mandalay Place. So you've got all sustainably sourced seafood items. You got ahi tuna, salmon, you've got some halibut, you've got yellowfin tuna, you've got Kona kampachi, ginger, a vegan roll. I mean, you name it, we have it. And boy, Saville, you go. I see you there quite often. So
yeah, I am. I'm a vegan, and they make.
That's enough from Saville. So anyway.
Oh, thank you very much. It's unbelievable, the abuse.
This is going to be a great event. It's so much fun hanging out with you guys. Glad you brought some fish just for the halibut.
No.
You come join us Saturday, April 1st at Caesar's Palace for the 60th annual celebration, St. Rose Dominican Health Foundation. Saville Kellner, Rick Moonen, two of my favorite people. Thank you so much for being
Kendall,
here today.
It's a pleasure.
Thanks for having us, Kendall.
All right. See you
Thanks.
Saturday.
Yep.
We'll be right back. Oh, let's go over to you, Lindsey. Sorry, didn't mean to preempt you. My
the
bad.
The dad joke threw you off. You had to get that dad joke in before the end of the segment. Well, the ACMs are taking place this Sunday, and we want to send you to the Party for a Cause concert for free. So stick around, because your chance to win is coming up next.
Tomorrow on Good Day,
we look back at some of your most asked questions for the sheriff.
All during our Morning Cup of Joe segment.
And more wind and a roller coaster of temps coming our way in your Weather Now forecast tomorrow on Good Day.
Pet Project on Las Vegas Now is sponsored by Best Mattress.
Being the largest furnace.
Just for you.
Oh, yum. You didn't bring any over, Kendall.
It's right there. Rick's transferring it to a plate because he wouldn't let us keep his plate.
Okay.
He said.
So we're going to get to try it?
Yeah.
Said, I like that at parties. I'm like, I am taking my plate. You do not get to keep my plate.
That's, yeah.
Well, welcome back, everyone. We're taking a look at what's trending now. And we kick things off with Adele, who's threatening to retire from touring.
No. And I don't know if I will ever tour again. I've loved it. I really, really have loved it.
Yeah, that was Adele over the weekend performing for a rain-soaked, sold-out crowd in New Zealand. The decision may be because of stage fright. Now, remember back in 2015, Adele spoke out about her stage anxiety. She told NPR that she gets so nervous with live performances that she gets frightened to try anything new. Mm. And she said that she feels like it's getting worse, or it's not getting better, but that feels worse because it should be getting better by this point. So
yeah.
If this is true, I'm devastated because I have not had the chance to see her. And she is amazing.
She really is. And it's always interesting to hear that. And I'm sure in the radio biz, you've heard of this all the time. Performers who have this anxiety, and you would think, what? It's Adele.
You would think with all the confidence that she has up there. And an Adele show, it's not just her voice. It's her sense of humor. It's like a comedy show and her singing. So, yeah, I agree with you. That would be devastating. But she was also saying at that concert that the applause really gets to her. She feels too humbled by it, like she doesn't deserve it. So I guess maybe if we promise not to clap, maybe she'll
just
keep
golf
doing
claps.
It.
We'll
boo you if
just
you keep
very
touring.
Polite claps, yes. Well done.
A recent reunion of the Fresh Prince cast was bittersweet as one piece of the group was missing. The cast recently got together, but James Avery, better known as Uncle Phil, was sadly not there. He passed away in 2014 on New Year's Day, and despite this mini reunion,
Fresh Prince fans, they may not see the Banks family back on TV. Alfonso Ribeiro, who played Carlton, said back in 2014, since the passing of my favorite dad in the world ever on TV, James Avery passed, the chances of a Fresh Prince coming back together will not happen. Without him, it just doesn't work. Mm.
I'd like to see it, though.
I know. I wish they would do something in honor of Uncle.
Yeah,
Bill, you know?
Yeah, maybe they will eventually.
I don't. I hope they don't.
What?
Because I am...
Take a stand, Lindsey.
I am so sick of these remakes and sequels, not just in TV, but like... in theaters and stuff.
Sentimental hogwash.
Let's do something. You can do one, like having one kind of reunion.
Yeah.
One episode. That would be amazing.
Right.
But to continue a whole series, I just don't like that stuff anymore.
Okay. I'm going to guess you didn't go see Chips in movie theaters over the weekend.
Which got terrible reviews, by the way.
Yeah.
But I will see Beauty and the Beast.
Oh, okay. Well, that's okay.
Fuller House? Did you see Fuller House?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
I'm afraid it would ruin it.
Yeah.
Coming up, my favorite time of the day. Find out more about this adorable little pooch and the puppy prize you'll receive if you adopt him.
But first, here is your chance to win tickets to four great ACM parties going on this week with the Academy of Country Music Awards coming to town. Stoney's is hosting parties Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, and you can get a pair of tickets to all four events by being caller number 8 to 792-8801. Parties include performances by Michael Ray, the Swan Brothers, Carter Winter, and Brody Stewart.
Las Vegas Now's performance set is sponsored by Stoney's Rockin' Country.
Back, everyone. It's time for this week's Pet Project. That's Bugsy right there. It's a segment sponsored by our friends over at Best Mattress. Laura Rodriguez joins us from NSPCA, and she brought along someone who needs a good home, little Bugsy boy here. So tell us a little bit about him.
He's awesome. He's a six-year-old chihuahua. If you look closely at him, you'll see he's got two different shaped eyes.
That's a leather couch.
He does!
But you know what? It makes him different. But you know what? As you've seen, he's a love bug.
He's precious. How old is he?
He's 6 years old.
6 years old, okay. And he came to you all recently, or?
He's been there about a week, week and a half. He just went up for adoption a couple days ago.
So let's talk a little bit about the adoption process. A friend of mine actually just rescued and adopted a pet. And can you tell people about how the process goes? Do you need to get like pre-approved?
No. We actually want people come on down to the shelter. Actually go to our website first and kind of scan and see if there's anyone you're interested in. Come on down, talk to the adoption counselor. We bring the dogs up to you so you can meet them. And you get to know them in an environment. We'll let you go outside and play with them. And it varies the time. You know, it can be a half hour, a little bit longer. But we really want you to come. And if you have any other animals, dogs, please bring the dogs down.
Oh.
Bring all the kids down. Let's make it a whole family experience.
That's nice that you allow that. And this is obviously Chihuahua or a Chihuahua breed?
He's a Chihuahua. He might have a little something else in him. I think he's got a pug nose.
A little something special.
Little something special.
So we were talking during commercial break that there are some misconceptions.
You know, Chihuahuas are, everyone thinks that they're ankle biters and all they do is bark. That's a bunch of myths. Chihuahuas, they used to hunt rats.
Okay.
Before they became domesticated. So, yeah, they're going to alert you. If someone knocks on your door, they're going to let you know there's someone there.
Right.
So they really don't bark a whole lot. Now, they can sometimes be ankle biters, but not that often.
Not that.
That's
Bugsy
just protecting you.
Bugsy seems like a nice little lap dog, so this is
he
great.
He is. He's the perfect lap dog. When I was driving over here, all he wanted to do was lay in my lap.
Oh. Well, let's find him a good home. If you're interested in Bugsy or adopting any other pet, head on over to NSPCA on Dewey Drive or call them at 702-873-7722. We'll be right back.
Hi there, guys. Las Vegas still buzzing over the Raiders. It is full speed ahead on a new stadium, but what do they do in the meantime? Because some city officials in Oakland are ready to kick them out right now. So how do we accommodate an NFL team until that new stadium is built? Where would it be? How fast could we get it ready? Katie Bower is looking into all of that for us. And you may not even feel it, but your taxes are going up this weekend. How that extra penny for every dollar spent is supposed to keep us all safer. And to keep us all a bit more sane, this app is promising to block robocalls. Consumer advocate Michelle Mortensen explains in tonight's 8 on Your Side. We hope you're ready to, for those stories in about 6 minutes. Meantime, though, the wind last night, Ted, could break wake you up out of a dead sleep.
Probably. I think we are the Windy City. This time of the year, yeah. We are the Windy City. And those winds, the good news, they have decreased quite a bit. So big gusts early today, as promised. And then later on in the afternoon, those winds now down to about, they're still double digits, but we've got light breezes down to the teens rather than those 20s. Tonight, 52 degrees, still some light breezes this evening, clearer and chillier. Temperatures drop into the 50s. Some locales like out in Summerlin, probably the high 40s overnight. That's it. Chilly morning. 79 degrees tomorrow, warmer. North breezes back in the forecast, but these winds are nowhere near what we saw today, and we have even stronger winds headed our way later on in the week. We'll talk about that coming up in your forecast in the 5 o'clock hour. Lindsey, Mercedes, and Kendall, the whole gang is back. The Three Musketeers. Send it back to you.
Thanks, Ted. Well, this little guy is feeling your struggles, having a difficult week, this guy feels, yeah. This video, too cute for words. The hedgehog is ready to take a bite, but can't balance itself and falls over. The struggle is real.
That's me on Sunday mornings.
I can't do it.
We had a hedgehog for a while.
Noelle. You did?
Yeah. Yeah, they were good little pets.
Was he fast?
No, because no, not especially.
Not like Sonic.
No.
I always wondered. Was there? No? Okay.
And he bounced over little obstacles.
Yeah. Thanks for joining us, guys. We'll see you again tomorrow.
Victim of a crash?